cards here.
Yeah.
That's weird. You scrolled all the way down, there's nothing more.
Put that emergency one in there. I didn't, that was my emergency one there.
That's weird. Well, maybe we'll just have to do it the old way, and then we'll get that link from her again. Was that, would she send that to you?
Yeah. Oh, sure. Chris would.
Ugh, Courtney.
You wouldn't believe. I had an email from Purina today. And I downloaded the thing it sent me, and then I wanted to send that to Ann.
Mm-hmm.
It's nowhere. It, she was in here with me. We went through everything. It's nowhere. But and it, I can prove I got it because I did download the contract.
Your computer just likes to
right
mess
there
with you.
Service Dog Project. That came from did not come out of an email. I mean, it's gone. Anyway, go ahead. So. What are we doing?
We're going to explore.
We're going to explore.
Yeah.
Is this thing on?
Yeah.
Okay, so if there's all huzzy and fuzzy and stuff like that, that's because we're on the wrong
thing. We're on the wrong thing because we can't find the email with the link, so sorry.
We lost the directions.
It's very annoying how fast you read. All of you people.
I know. The pups enjoyed their excursion today. Yeah, I came in. I happened to stop in for something. I forget why I came in here, and I heard Jade in there, and she went, no, no, no. And she's yelling, no, absolutely not. Stomping her feet. And I came around the corner, and they're all just, like, attacking her. And I said, Jade, just open. Oh, they're going nuts. Like, open that back door. And she was like, what? And I was like, open the back. She opened the back door. They all took off, and they ran right into the condos, and they're up and down, and they're up and they're down, they're up the ramps, and they're down the ramps. And I was like, I'll be the hall monitor. You go inside, and you can fluff the inside. And she was like, thank you. I'm like, you're welcome. So I went out there, and I played with them on the ramps. And
They go all over the whole thing?
All over the whole thing. They start at the bottom, and they jump on the lower bed.
They don't make poos and things?
They made poos on the porch. One pooped inside. I don't know which one it was, but it was a little loose, so I don't blame them for that. But yeah, they go on the lower bed, up onto the big platform, and then they run up there, onto the lower bed, and down. And then when they try and go this way, it's a big leap up, so I'd have to scoot their boots up on the bottom. And then a lot of them just wanted to sit there and chew wood, which was fine. But the nutty ones that were in here giving her a hard time were literally just looping. So, and then everyone, I was like, just keep them out here. And you just have to stand here. I mean, you can practice recalling individual ones that look like they want to talk to you, but for the most part, let them
run.
They
are doing beautifully at one cookie at a time.
Yes. I saw that. I saw some pictures of people.
And I'm pushing it into their mouth.
Good.
They're not biting at it.
Chomping.
Chomping is terrible with those damn teeth.
I know.
And I got it, so I put my back of my hand and then shove it in the mouth.
That's good. Mike is fine. No hissing at all. Well, that's nice. When do the puppies go to the condo? We just open them up whenever. It'd be, I mean, not that we need another explore cam, but it would be nice. It would be cool if we had a cam mounted, just because They have so much fun back there, and I can only take so many videos of them playing, but it'd be fun for people to watch. But
maybe. How did we get that?
We did that cam before.
How did
green
we get
one
out there?
I don't know.
We had a big roll of wire here.
Yeah, we did. We did.
We can certainly get it out the back window, but not into the room.
Hmm. Pixie's doing great. She's a great dog, with Stacy. She put a post on Bookface today. Did you see it? Did somebody email it to you?
I think somebody sent that to
me. Her coming out of the
Hospital,
and yep. The nurse came, brought the dog in, and all that stuff. Yep. How much do the gifts weigh? If I had to guess, I would say 17 and a half pounds.
Really?
Do you know? Do you have a paper in there? Do you have a book? Sometimes there's a puppy book around. No, it's not a big deal if they don't have one. I'd guess 17 pounds. For a while, they were approaching 12, 13 a little while ago, so.
There's a couple that are up into the 20s, aren't there?
Yeah. You totally need more cams. You send explore emails, talk about
it. No,
more.
No.
Yeah.
I think that wire might be downstairs, in which case we can pull it up through there.
And then
we might make it across the kitchen.
Yeah.
It's these wires hanging all over the place that are kind of wild.
Is it an explore thing with the amount of cams, or can another one be hooked in? Anytime we get a new one or do anything like that, generally they have set it. They came in that last. That was when they redid all of our modems and stuff.
And they took a whole big box of stuff back.
Yeah, huge, huge.
And a big box. It basically went into a 4-foot cube.
Yeah.
Of Express.
Yeah.
FedEx.
Yeah, we had
a lot of cams,
a lot of equipment.
And wires.
Yeah, it was
all that stuff. They took all that.
It was a lot. So, which dog is the next to be matched? We're trying to shift some dogs around. The next match is probably going to be Kringle. She's end of March, and then we have a couple people coming in for interviews in between. But Steve and I were chatting that we're hoping by, what was the date we gave out? April. I think we said it by April 1st or May 1st, we want all the other big dogs gone. So we're just down to Sizzle's group. So Podrick, Brad, Ned, and then all the authors, and then these guys. So that's our deadline for mentally for the 10. I think there's 8 others. 8?
You got one you're washing.
One that we're washing. Now they're going to ask me, who is it? We'll wait for that one to come through. I need more. Currently have all cams open. I love it. That's fun. Yep, you could mount the GoPro on the wall, record video throughout the day, and then post it online.
Yeah.
We could do that. I could also do.
How to work the freaking GoPro.
I know the GoPros can be confusing. We have if the Wi-Fi is strong enough. So a lot of the times Courtney wants us to go live on Facebook, but we have an issue with the Wi-Fi in here that it's not strong enough. So we can test it out back, and if it's strong enough, we could go live with a live video through Facebook. We'll
understand that at all.
We'll think about it.
Through Facebook, what camera would it be?
My phone becomes the cam.
Oh, okay. That's what we did at your house? No.
No, we did it once. You and I did it once in here when Noelle first had her puppies. Was it Noelle? Yeah, Noelle's puppies. Which dog is going to be a perfect pet? Pilot is. She is beautiful. She's a great dog. Perfect. Behaved always since when she was little. She was really, really great, but she just paces and moves weird and doesn't do well with the pressure on the back, so, or the shoulders I should say. But she will be a perfect pet for someone.
Actually, she's going to be doing therapy work, right?
Yeah, hopefully she'll join with Goldie and go out on excursions if we can. That'd be good. GoPro, can we mount them on the dogs? We did that once.
I have it right here.
They have. Did you see the chest mounts? You will have one.
Somebody gave it to us, or I bought it. I don't know how I got it. But at any rate, my GoPro, it's a number 2.
Now they're at like 6 or
I know.
Something.
And this one, I can't even get past the red light being on.
So this would blow your mind. So my boyfriend has a GoPro Hero, whatever, the newest one that they have, okay? He can take a video, so it's here, and he'll record it. Connects wirelessly Bluetooth to my cell phone, and I can upload the videos right there and then send them off. So it's no longer this like plugging them in, and like with that one we have to like plug it in.
In other words, I'll just go buy another one.
Maybe. Yeah.
Well, if I can't even turn it on and off, for heaven's sakes, we got a long way to go to try and do anything with it.
Happy Valentine's Day.
All right.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day. What are we doing? Oh, God. I thought we were...
Go ahead, sex bag.
A handshake. Oh, my God.
Yes, and a hearty handshake as well.
Yeah. All right. Well, you ready for mail call, Steve?
I'll be right there.
All
right.
You can have a... Oh, oh. Carlene doesn't like the healthy chocolate. It's dark chocolate.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Oh, thank you.
Well, I need more chocolate. I already had one of the last pieces. There's still cake out there.
Oh,
that
God.
That wonderful cake I bought.
Why'd you buy cake?
I forgot.
The 19th of
March. Somebody sent me to Costco and they had cake on there, a dessert or something. I don't know. It was on my list. So I buy it.
I don't know.
It's not the 19th yet, is it?
It's almost. It's the 16th.
Somebody made a suggestion.
What?
Oh, then I should take eggs.
What?
To the fire department.
Eggs?
You've got so many eggs.
All right, I can breathe now.
Well, we had them for a while. I collect them somewhere.
No, yeah, that's a good idea.
Three fresh eggs. A couple dozen fresh eggs.
It's a really good idea.
Nope.
All right. You're on.
Bye.
Okay,
bye.
I'm
good
on.
To see you, Annie.
Hey, Megan.
Yeah.
See you later.
Hey, Steve. Thanks for coming in today.
Hey. My pleasure, really, really. No, really, honestly.
Oh, boys. It's getting deep in here. Stop chewing.
Is that for me?
Sure.
Start chewing? You want me to chew in the box? Is that
sure.
Okay.
Anything to turn you on?
Well, you know, chewing cardboard doesn't quite do it for me, but, you know, I'm willing to give it
so
a shot.
So good brandy.
Well, now you're talking.
Okay.
Whiteboard, or are
Hello.
You doing your computer
whiteboard? I'll do digital.
Okay. Hi.
How are you?
Good.
You got enough stools. You got two stools?
Yeah, two of them. Oh, Linda, damn it. I've got something in my... Oh, my... Ah, crap. I'm in out of hearts.
Okay.
I have something in my car.
Should I start opening this stuff?
Start opening.
Okay, this is from Amy. Athens, Georgia.
Athens, Georgia.
Man.
I believe they have a mini Parthenon there, a replica of the Parthenon.
A mini Parthenon?
Parthenon.
Parthenon?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Goodness. It's a good thing I started this early here. Huh. Okay. I always like to stay way up on the top here, just in case there's something in there I'm not supposed to cut up. I better not even try that one. I don't like that. Let's go the other way. There we go. I don't think. Did you see if there's anything in there?
Just the inside of the bag.
Well, here we go. Found this.
Amy Barb.
Found this one. I hope someone at Servant Dog Project could use it. GA dogs. That interesting. Oh. Okay. That looks like maybe a Grace type vest, wouldn't it be? Yeah, 3X.
Good.
That's a Grace thing, isn't it?
Grace!
Where's Grace?
She's down at the chickens.
Would you want to hold that for Grace? There you go. We found a home for it already. Thanks for the many hours of entertainment. Grace needs bundling up, too, so that'll be a good thing. She gets out with old. Okay.
There's a lot of people out there.
Yes.
I can spell.
You can what?
Athens, Georgia. Just that I can spell.
Guess who loves you today? Oh, boy. How are we going to do this? What are we going to do? Whoa! Something fell out.
Sorry.
Got it. Mm-hmm. Got it. Put it in the pot. We haven't got the pot. There comes the pot. Okay.
It looks like it's Carlene. I can't tell.
This is to sizzle.
I'm gonna go with KR.
Huh. What is that? Before banking in a padded envelope. Oh, that's because of the head wobbles. Look at that. Are you paying attention?
I am, to the envelope.
No, look.
Oh, what is it? Look. The dog's got a loose neck.
My favorite house dog. You know, I took Sizzle into Costco today. I had more compliments on her.
What a beautiful dog.
She is gorgeous. I always thought Bentley was gorgeous. I don't get as many compliments on, you know, it's a brilliant dog.
He's a very handsome.
This was ridiculous.
She's a beautiful dog. She really is. I like her.
I should pay more attention to her, I guess.
Yeah, you
okay,
should.
Okay, this is for Pete Gift. From somebody in, well, could be New Jersey, could be Wyoming.
That's quite a difference.
10533, maybe that's Jersey. I don't know.
That should be East Coast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure looks like Wyoming otherwise, though.
Which, well, it could be Wyoming. You know, there's a Wyoming in Maine, isn't there? Hey, Linda.
I was just going for the Y.
Hope so.
Maybe it's New York.
I owe you some chocolate.
Ithington, New York or something.
Well, that's a cute card. Steve?
What's that?
Is that a card? That's cute.
That is a cute card.
I'm going to hold that one up for a minute.
Sizzles.
Violets are tiny, roses are smelly. Valentine candy belongs in your belly.
Now you're talking.
I don't think you'll get any candy, but for a buck, Miss Carly may give you extra Alpo treat or three. Bobbity. Well, that's very nice. I'll put that in there. And then you can have this, and you can try and figure out where it is. I think it's Ithington, New York, though. It looks like Wyoming, though, doesn't it? W-Y.
It's New York. Irvington, New
Irvington.
York.
Irvington, yeah, something like that.
Who's the person?
Well, I don't know.
Well, you know. Oh, Bobbity 212.
Look, here we go. What do we got in here? Look, it's Cupid. Harold and Wanda. Oh, is it?
DM spell check. Whoop.
This is a private joke of some kind. I shouldn't open. Linda!
Yeah?
I opened your card. I didn't notice.
You got a card?
Wait till we get it back in the envelope. There we go. You can have it now. Here you go. That's for Linda. I don't always look. Okay. This is from Bellows. Williamstown, New Jersey. This is Williamstown, New Jersey. They are making their own cards. All these people are.
They're nice.
They are.
It's actually not that difficult to do.
You're going to look in the envelope.
I'm going to look in the envelope.
I'm going to look in the envelope.
Would you like me to look in the envelope?
Look in the envelope.
How about this?
Please do. Oh, yeah, right. I like Johnny Carson.
Yeah. Karnak. Bellow author. No name, so I will need that after.
I got to get the staple up. Heart full of love, especially for you, Valentine's Day, for everyone at Service Dog Project. This is from Renee. That's a cute picture.
Thank you, Harold and Wanda.
Oh, Harold and Wanda.
Yeah.
Oh,
it was
Renee.
Very nice of them.
Okay.
Roses are red.
Lucia. L-U-C-A. L-U-C-A. Lucia? Lucasville, Ohio?
I don't know. I'll let you know when I see it.
Okay.
Roses are red, violets are purple. I like pancakes with maple syrup.
We have one in here that I'm ashamed that you didn't think of.
All right. I can't wait to see it.
Cupid wants to wish you happy Valentine's Day. Here we go. First, thank you for sharing your home with everyone to see the wonderful work you do. I don't do an awful lot of work. There's an awful lot of other people. Although I must say, these puppies are coming now. I thought we were going to have to throw them all out the window. But they all sat there today and looked at me and ate their cookies and waited for the next one. They were wonderful.
Nice.
They really were very good.
It just takes a little time and attention. Both of which you have.
Okay. Enjoyed watching the many hours of people and puppy fun. Second, $5 included for Lainey and her gifts for Valentine's Day. Last, $10 included for my first chicken brick.
Nice.
I hope to join the Shatterpond Society. Never in my life did I think I would say that. Jennifer, thank you for everything you do. Isn't that wonderful? Thank you. So this goes into the chicken shit department over here.
Oh, there you go.
I was in a very fancy lawyer's office today.
Yeah.
Trying to explain what the hell the Shatterpond Society was. And everybody laughing so hard that they'd miss half the description, you know?
Right.
And then they'd what, we'd all start again. Mostly, they didn't believe it. Okay, this is Appleton. W.I.
Wisconsin.
That would be... What am I, a horse?
You're going to look at the envelope, right? You're going to look at the envelope. Bing and Gromit. Sisters in Wisconsin, Sherry and Deanne. Well, that's very nice. Thank you. I'm glad you're watching from Wisconsin. Put that back on the map. Okay. Now that I know how to get his dander up. This is Appleton, Wisconsin again. We have the second one from somebody there.
All right. Sherry and Deanne.
Okay. There you go.
Yep.
There we go. Happy Valentine's Day. This is to Marvin Lint. Special place in our hearts. And all the other critters at Crazy Acres. Sherry and Deanne. The two sisters in Wisconsin. Two sisters. And here we go with Margaret Stevenson. Timberlake, Ohio. Wait a minute, this one looks like it has a letter. No? Greetings from Timberlake, Ohio. Here we go. We owe you postage for the two calendars and poker chips we received a week or two ago. We're waiting on the two six-foot rope leashes. So here's postage and some extra for that. Great thank yous for everything. Arlen and Midge. I made those 2 6-foot leashes. They should have them by now. Unless somebody around here used them before they got in the mail.
That could be.
So Arlen and Midge, I hope you get them very soon, and if you don't, let me know. I'll just make some more. Alias Izzy Payne. Izzy a Payne. Oh, my word. Friend of... Huh. Is that one of these people? Is Izzy a Payne?
I think so.
Huh. That's pretty funny. So anyway, this is... I'm going to put this in the... in Linda's department, because those leashes shouldn't be out of here.
Jody Colburn says she doesn't think many of the CPs are old enough to remember Karnak. Oh, I don't know.
That could be. You know, his humor was what I think is really funny, though.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean,
he
would take anything that came at him and go with it. You know, because he never knew what some of these crazy guests he had. Some of them sober and some of them not so sober.
Or is it?
Chaos. This is for chaos. Happy Valentine's Day. Please give your famous stink eye to the hateful politicians. And the $2 bills to Carlene. Here you go. Okay. That's cute. He'll take it out of my hand pretty soon. I'll just sit here.
Come on, you can do it.
Oh, boys. And here's just a blank something. This is going to be a bill or somebody. American Indian College Fund. I got enough dealing with this charity. I don't need another charity, Donor renewal form inside. I don't think this is...
Dean Martin was on Johnny Carson one night. Johnny Carson had a cup of coffee and water in front of him. Dean Martin was smoking. Every time Johnny Carson would look away, he'd flick the ashes
in
it.
He wasn't Johnny. This was the guy who kept all the Japanese people out of Oklahoma. He was in the service, and they stationed him in Oklahoma.
Sounds good. We'll have a good night. Do you want to take something?
Very droll.
George Gobel?
No. Ever think that the world is a tuxedo and you're a pair of brown
that
shoes?
That was George Gobel.
No.
Yeah.
I bet you a nickel on it.
I'll bet you a nickel.
You got it.
Okay.
I just happen to have that disc right here.
Okay. You ever feel like you were the world was a tuxedo and you were a pair of
brown
shoes.
Right.
I remember that.
Okay, so that, we don't need that one either. This is from Iona Ford. How many of these do we get a week? 3 that we get a week? I can give up chocolate, but I'm not a quitter.
Now you're talking.
That's cute. Okay.
That's a good one.
That is a good
one.
That's
a very good one.
That's a good one. What the hell is that guy's name?
I'm going to look it up.
Because he was the one that had the drink, and Dean Martin kept flicking his ashes into it. Actually, Bob Hope was on the same, yeah, the same night, I think. Harold Wanda.
Harold Wanda,
eating their cereal. And giving us that picker. I hope this is for a monkey fist. I got an awful lot of monkey fists.
Buy a couple more of
them. I got an awful lot of monkey fists here. Come on, guys. Let's get with the program here. This is for somebody. I'm going to read it off this one. This is... Oh, boys, I'm not happy that I did that. Can't read it. Maybe it's on here. I haven't purchased chicken, Rick, but I have donated to service in the past. If you'd like to send me one of your monkey fists, it would be certainly appreciated. Sir, of course. I'll send you a couple of them here. I can't pronounce your last name, though.
It's Took. Szczesinski.
Here, you try it. This one, you can read that one better.
All right.
Of course, we'll get some monkey piss in here right away.
Except it's spelled different on the envelope than it is on the paper.
There we go. I'm going to send them too.
All right.
So, and then we have to send them.
What's the monkey? A couple of these things in here. Hopefully, give them away.
There's a couple of poker chips to give to your friends. How's that?
There you go.
Something is smelling good. Something is smelling like food.
Tracy's making fish, and it smells great.
It does smell good. There we go.
Hey, I've been there.
Is that a bag ought to hold together? Where, Eastern Pennsylvania?
Yeah, we went through there once.
Okay. There you go. I couldn't figure out what your name was, but you're getting them. Oh, we got another one of those. Okay.
Aya.
Okay. Okay. There'll be a slight delay. That snow was awful messy that we got last night. You know that?
I know. But at least it's Did you ever get the feeling that the world was a tuxedo when you were a pair of brown shoes? George Goebel, you owe me a nickel.
Can I go put this on? What? It could be that that guy's name is George Goebel, but I didn't think that was his name. Could be.
That's okay.
Okay.
It must be true. It's on the internet.
That's right.
Philadelphia, PA.
That could be his name. I thought George Goebel was somebody else. Okay, hello.
Wait, I've got him mixed up with
Believe
someone.
It or not, I ordered this the day Bailey died and wanted something for her memory, so I hope you like it. Lady in Russia made it for me. I made it out of felt. Clever idea. I'm a CP since 14. I watch you every day. So I'm waking and watching when I get home. You and your staff do a wonderful job. Know that you're changing lives all over the world. I tell so many people about your organization. You're such a dedicated people and volunteers. You are funny if you don't know it. Oh, okay. You make so many people laugh. So I pray for you all the time, workers that help you and your volunteers and, of course, your CPs. Your few dollars to put in the fun. Hopefully, one day I will get to Crazy Acres and volunteer. That's from Nora. Hide and Chaos, Bentley, is her favorite, Pockets. There we go. Okay. I'll look good in there. There we go. Oh my word! Isn't that gorgeous?
Oh, look at that!
Isn't that
gorgeous? It looks like Bailey.
It's certainly the faces.
That's great.
That is wonderful. Thank you very much. It has to go up on the mantelpiece.
Okay.
Did you get that in the mantelpiece?
I will in a bit. Right here, just for a minute.
Wow.
That's beautiful.
Huh. What a good job she did. Huh. Well, that's very nice. Thank you very much. I better keep the business cards in case we need to know that.
Carlene and staff. Blue Mountain Arts. Angels are everywhere. Put that over here. Sometimes we feel we're all alone as life brings us challenges to overcome and hardships to bear, but when we least expect it, help can appear. Maybe a kind word from a stranger and a phone call at just the right moment. Miracles happen every day. Angels are everywhere. Well, I know Goldie is everywhere. That's from Nora. Well, thank you, Nora. That's a very nice card. See the card?
Hey, fun kill.
Hey.
Oh no, I lost my digital whiteboard.
I didn't have anything else to open. No boxes? No boxes.
I lost my digital whiteboard, so I'm going to read them off in a minute.
Okay.
We'll do an audio whiteboard tonight. Let's put Bailey up on the counter.
Okay.
I mean, I can handle.
What am I supposed to do?
Put it right there so you can see it from your chair.
What are we doing?
We're doing audio whiteboard before we go any further.
Oh. I'm not doing anything, right?
Take a break. Okay, first we're going to show this because this is just really cool.
Sure.
Okay, you can play with this.
Well, thank you.
And you know what? I think I was... It is George Goldwell, but I think I was incorrect. He wasn't flicking the ashes in Johnny Carson's cup. Dean Martin was sitting next to George Goldwell, and he was flicking his ashes
in his... That's what I just told you.
In his cup.
I just told you that.
Yeah, but you said... Well, never mind.
I didn't know what the guy's name was, but I had the right idea.
Yeah, you did. Okay, Nora Coyne. Thank you. Looks like Trzynski. Thank you. Harold and Wanda. Thank you.
It does look like it is, George.
Iona Ford, whoever you are.
It does. The name is there. It does look like it's George Goble.
Anon, whoever you are. Margaret Stevenson. And this was the sisters.
What are you dropping?
Oh, my whole week has been like this.
Well, you got the George Goble part right.
Oh, see, there you go.
And you made a nickel. I have a nickel in here.
Yeah, hold that for me. Will you for a minute?
I have a nickel.
You can put the nickel in the fund. Really. Sherry and Deanne Peel. Thank you.
How about holding Bailey up for us to see?
Okay, we'll do that too. Jay Copus. Peel.
It was Steve Goble.
No, it was George Goble. Nora Coyne.
Oh, I do remember the potato chip collection.
Mitchell? What's that? Who what?
This the night that the woman brought in all the potato chips that looked like something.
And
she had, oh, God, she had a beautiful collection of very weird-looking potato chips.
And she looked away
for a minute, and Johnny reached behind his desk and got a potato chip and ate it. And there was this crunch. And she looked around. Yeah, that was,
I don't remember that.
That was a good moment.
I don't remember that one. This is somebody from Irvington, New
York. His timing was just so good.
He makes
these stand-up comics look sick.
Bobbity 212. Amy Barb. Nora Coyne. Williamstown, New Jersey. Nora Coyne. So if I missed anybody, just comment in and I will read you out.
What on earth are they doing now?
Let me make sure I get all these.
How much are the monkey fists?
got
the monkey
feels.
I have a thing on there. If you go buy a chicken brick, I'll send you one. You send me an envelope.
You don't afford mine. Okay, I think I got all of these. All right.
This is my first time listening to mail chatter. I never thought of calling it that.
Mail chatter. Well, maybe she meant mail shatter. I don't know.
We live in Rentham, Mass.
Oh.
Love seeing the dogs and sizes.
It is so cool. Even the markings are all, I think, accurate.
The face is spectacular.
It's great.
Yeah, Johnny Carson was the best at letting his guests shine.
Awesome?
He was good. You know who I thought should have taken his place?
Who's that?
I'll have to work and remember. Ellen DeGeneres.
Uh-huh.
She's got that same casual, you know,
uh-huh,
cool attitude about her that would have been interesting. Did you give Gaiser the fit you, Grace?
Huh?
Oh, good.
What?
Give it to you.
We have a gift.
We had a gift for you.
Yes. We got a lot of making up to do here.
How's that?
Yeah.
Very
cool.
Good thing?
Yeah.
Wonderful. Perfect.
Wonderful.
Here, I did have this.
Wonderful.
I told you, put it in the fun.
Yeah, it's a funny name, nickel, though.
Oh, it's one of the new ones.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, so now you have a new nickel. Now you've lost it.
Now I lost it. And the kids found out that Jimmy had a nickel. Jimmy had a nickel.
Your crumb thing? Are you falling apart, Greg?
Here you go.
Fun, fun. I don't know if I can move anymore.
Well, let's sit there for a while. I'll
tell you anything.
You did get your egg cartons.
I did?
Right there by your hand.
You know, I have some in the back of my car.
I was going to put a dozen and a half in the car, but somebody has their car locked. You think if we're
going to
thieve it?
Oh, me?
Yeah. Your car's locked.
It was suggested.
I just happened. I'm sorry.
How many eggs we get in a day now?
Ricky's coop, I actually got 8. I don't know. Ryan must have picked them earlier, but he didn't do Ricky's coop, so I had 8 out of there.
Because somebody suggested we take them to the fire department, this one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay. Very colorful.
That's a very good idea.
Yeah, very cool. Okay, what today is?
December 15th?
There'll be lots more, believe me.
Yeah. No, we can save them.
You're getting a couple of dozen.
Yeah,
I'll
put them in my basket.
Why don't you save them for the and I'll take them.
Right.
It's fun. They cook all the time.
There's almost like 18 of them down there already. I need one more egg and then another dozen and a half.
Okay.
I have cards.
What are we doing?
All right, I'm catching up.
Hey, up.
There's a picture of the Parthenon in Nashville, Tennessee. I guess. I'm sure there's one in Georgia. I'm sure there is. And there's a classic Johnny Carson Karnak we need to watch after.
Oh, yes.
With the envelope. Then the comment about the CPs not being old enough to remember.
Oh, please.
105-33 is mine, Irvington, New York. I sent 10 in total on the 7th, and most of them got there last Friday, so Pete's went astray.
Hard?
I guess.
I'm starting to fall off now because we have quality tape.
That looks pretty cool in there, though.
Oh, yeah.
Homemade cards are beautiful, but they're hurting Hallmark. Oh, well.
There were some nice homemade ones in there. I can tell.
Penguin. That's a good idea. Just a towel.
Oh, Blue Penguin says you can probably make me one. A Karnak hat. I'll show it to you after.
Yeah.
Okay. Auntie Ross. Rose.
Auntie Rose.
Auntie Rose. I was thinking SDP gets so many postage stamps. Isn't there any charity organization who would like to have them? Or you can sell them somewhere somehow.
Really?
Oh, yeah, some people.
Some people do collect them.
Yeah.
But I don't know, once they're...
Regular old postage?
No, but let's ask my aunt. She saves her stamps and gives them somewhere.
Really?
But once they're stamped, though, then aren't they worthless or no?
No, it's not.
Are you going to wrap his head?
Why not?
I could do a carnet. All right, now I'm going to do my hand this way. I'm ready.
Ready?
I'm ready.
I don't know how good
this will
go.
You know.
Don't wiggle too much because it'll fall off.
Don't wiggle.
What are you
gonna? I need an envelope.
Yeah, try that one.
See if you can read it. It's from.
I own a Ford.
Not a Chevrolet.
Who's from Pennsylvania? We don't know who they are, but we'll figure it out. All right. Are the majority of donkeys outside only see, oh, thanks, can't move, see three more? Yeah, they're kind of in and out all the time. You just have to keep watching. Yeah, exactly. Hi, Rye. Yes, I have a funny cat.
You have to play follow the leader to get him to go outside. I did that yesterday.
Dogs are best.
Just put the hay out there.
Huh?
Just put hay out there.
Yeah, but sometimes they don't get it, so I didn't.
Well, don't put it. They're not going to starve.
No, they're not. No, but I wanted to have it cleared out yesterday, so I did follow the leader. I took two slices because I already had put hay in the thing, feeder, and they didn't come out. So I'm like, okay, I'll do follow the leader.
No, don't put any more in the feeder inside. No. Take a couple chunks and throw them up the hill, and that'll get them making tracks up.
I have a whole box of apple slices from school too for them. So
that's good.
They'll like those.
And we have more damn carrots. I bought carrots again to put in us, and we've got leftover baby carrots. Get rid of them. Leave the the new ones out.
AZ Rock says, Johnny Carson was the best at letting his guests shine, and when he would laugh, America would laugh with him. Nothing like today's host.
Funny.
A couple of the new hosts are funny, but not...
They don't have the timing.
They don't have the timing like he did, you're right.
And the brains of it. He really...
Welcoming a new CP to Mail Call.
Oh, good.
Oh, yeah, here's the video of Bob Hope, Dean Martin, and George Goble.
That's George Goble.
Yeah, he had short hair, and he was very, very kind of dry and bland. And, but
yeah,
because
he was
very
in the Army.
Funny.
He was in the Army once, and the Army saw fit to send him to Oklahoma. And he was very proud to announce that he hadn't allowed any Japanese to get beyond Kansas City.
All right, they're answering a lot of their own questions here, which is good. All right, ask Lucy Lou. Ask Carlene.
Somebody out there in the kitchen break up that if they're going to get nasty.
Ask Carlene if she remembers the old... Oh, this is the potato chip collection. You just mentioned that, yeah. Okay, we have 50 new comments to go through here.
Okay, I'm ready.
All right, let me get back here. All right, we're going to go through these real quick.
Okay.
Well, I already held up the Bailey statue. Right.
Yeah.
I did that. How was your day? How was Sizzle's training going?
Sizzle was superb. I tell you, once you get her off this damn farm, she was right on the button. I took her into the lawyer office thing I had to do today, and I went in two stores. I went to three places today.
Really?
It's unusual for me.
I know, you were gone a long time.
I was gone a long time, and I got tired.
Look at her, she's tired.
She's been out playing after that, too.
Oh, yes, but she was good.
She's been Goobies on Honeymoon Hill.
Really?
When I was shoveling the kennels out there.
Oh, that's
yeah.
fine. She's a beautiful dog.
She is a beautiful dog, I guess. Yeah, everybody stop and
talk
to her.
Very well behaved.
Working hard at trying to move that bed.
Oh, Betty lost her dad today. Sorry, Betty. Very sorry. Whoop. Thanks. Thanks, Rye. You made me lose my place. Your big butt. Carson had perfect timing and those funny zingers. Yeah, it did. Some swan from Virginia says it did look like Bailey, especially the face.
Yeah.
It is amazing. It really does. The markings and everything are, they look correct. Oh no, I got back to Iona for it. I did. Carlene would have enjoyed Nova on PBS last night. It was about the ancient art of origami.
Oh.
Is inspiring science to use its principles for innovation. Something folded tightly is small and is da-da-da-da-da. Solar panels in space and many more, for example.
No good.
Oh.
I'll try.
Give it a shot. We have a guy at school that does origami. He has from this big up to like this big, his whole classroom is full of them.
He's got a whole bunch of $1 bills done up.
Oh, is that right?
Wow.
Oh, really?
Oh, wow.
Huh.
Sort of starbursty thing. What did you want to do next?
Riot become so attached to Grace? A leash? No, I. No, Grace just took her on early.
She's very pretty.
Riot
she's
is very,
very
attached
oh,
to Grace.
Oh, she's
now.
Very, very pretty. She's very, very, very pretty. She's very pretty.
I think I was a little too close with the Bailey statue. I'll do it again and move back a little. All right, they're talking about purchasing bricks and getting...
Bricks is good.
Well, they've got the video of him eating the potato chip on here, too.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. So, that's great. Thank you. Thanks, Rye. Second time for you.
That's a good-looking dog, though. You know,
she
never should have paid her.
Doris Hoffman, the second letter post tasted in today's DD was about Princess Ruckus, and their second anniversary was from Caroline in New York, not Debbie. Caroline is so sweet and loves Ruckus so much. Carlene talked about training in the DD. Can she explain what she meant by dogs learning that if they behave correctly, they will not get hurt?
I never thought of it that way. The dog, we got out of my car and I put the harness on her and we're just standing there nice and quietly, and this car went past and hit this puddle and it scared her. But she didn't bolt. She just kind of stayed there with me and said, you know, what's that? Is that all right if we just stand here? What are we going to do? And it was the fact that she was looking to me to make sure that she didn't get hurt in the puddle. That was the... Oh, I never thought of anybody saying I was going to hurt the dog. No. No, these dogs are timid. The Great Danes are not brave souls. They wouldn't run up to anybody and bite them.
So do you mean more like they feel safe with you?
Feel safe with me, and that's why they stay with me.
Yeah.
And I think that has a lot to do with the early training of them. They just know it. They'll be all right, and they just kind of follow you.
Camop Joe has a link here about saving stamps, so we'll have to take a look at that as well.
Oh, brother. That's another... We got enough to problem with the cardboard on the front porch. Jesus. She's very needy today. I don't know what her problem is.
Well, I stopped rubbing her butt. That was the problem, huh? I stopped... Oh, I'm losing my color. Losing my personality here. Did you see Clover moving the yellow water bucket around?
Ready?
No.
Hungry?
Are we ready?
It's ready.
Dinner's ready.
Okay, come. We got a few more. We're almost. I'm wearing how do you explain it?
Turban.
An impromptu Karnak hat. Karnak the Great. Chaos needs a fluffy.
Oh.
Carlene, did you get your epoxy floor completed yet? If so, could you send? It is gorgeous.
It is gorgeous floor, but you can't walk on it yet.
Yeah, not yet, yeah.
It's got to be a week, they thought.
Oh, it's beautiful. When I saw it, I couldn't believe it. It was
beautiful. They did a good job. They did a good job.
We will get some pictures of it. With the pups getting so big, is it possible to let them have the arena to burn off some of that puppy energy? Or is it still too cold?
We couldn't get them all down there. They don't follow you that well yet.
Well, go ahead.
We get them out onto the into the back of the condo.
Uh-huh.
And they're up and down and up and down and up and down. But the camera's not out there, so we have to work on that.
The thing with the arena, too, is there are a lot of small spaces that they could get into, and then we would have a lot of difficulty getting them out.
That's right. They don't behave
they
quite well enough yet.
So when they get a little bigger. Have you seen the new cans of the sheep and goats? I haven't, but have you?
No.
Not yet?
No.
Dogs are best. Carlene, you sound a lot better today. The top shelf stuff must have worked.
I hate to tell you the rest of that story.
Go for it.
I've been absolutely miserable for 2 days with probably with a kidney stone.
Ooh.
Very painful. But I went out this morning and I rode on that damn tractor and bounced it out of all
shook it loose.
I don't have it anymore.
You did your own ultrasound, huh?
We have more potholes in that driveway.
So
I just thought that Cummings that gave us that 100,000. How much did they give us? 50,000 a year, 2 years.
Yeah, 2 years. That's right.
They are in the building business. They're building condos and all sorts of stuff. I'm going to write them a letter and say, gee, if you have any extra hot top, could you please send them up our way and do our driveway? Because whenever they do those big parking lots, they always have extra hot top.
Hmm. Yeah.
It would really help tremendously. Because I hate to. I mean, to hire somebody to come in and do it would be an awful lot of money. But somebody ought to be able to hot top our driveways.
Good idea. That's a good idea. Have you ever tried a riot bringing Bailey's basket at mail call? She seems to not mind stuff in her mouth.
I haven't tried it.
Thank you all. Enjoy your dinner. Now we're going to hold the Bailey thing up one more time with my Carnac hat. I'm going to go a little further away this time. Try to hold it still for a little longer.
We're coming down the home stretch in there at dinner. That's good.
Yeah. All right.
Okay.
All right. Thank you, everyone. Good night.
Good night.
Sleep tight.
Oh, boys. Timing was wonderful.